Coming up on Saturday, February the 10th, the 1058 Event Center in Sandusky has got a very cool show featuring America's escape hero, Michael Griffin. He's on the mix lines with us right now. How you doing, sir?
Doing pretty all right. I was tied up earlier, but now I'm free.
A little escape artist humor, eh?
Oh, yeah. We must weave in the magical puns whenever we can.
Now, this guy is an escape artist. You may have caught him on America's Got Talent, and he's done some...
No. That's America's Most Wanted. I'm always the guy who steals the bike.
There you go. But the one question I have to ask you, after watching some of your videos on YouTube and some of the amazing things you've done, why? How did this all become an interest?
Believe it or not, my dad was a psychiatrist, and he, for some reason, I used to always watch these shows on television where you could always beat up the guy, tie up the guy, and he'd always get out next week, you know, stay tuned to that Bat channel.
Okay.
And I would have dad tie me up forever, and I would always get out. I would always have my brother tie me up. I could always get out. I'd tie my brother up. He couldn't get out, but we still feed him twice a day. I loved the magic. I loved the escapes. And then when I was 16, because I grew up in California, and when I was 16, my dad goes, "Hey, Mike," because that's my name, "what kind of a car do you want for your birthday?" I said, "Dad, I don't want a car." He goes, "You're 16. We live in California. You have to have a car." I said, "Dad, I don't want a car." He goes, "Oh, God, what do you want?" I said, "Could I have a straitjacket?" And so I actually got a straitjacket. I borrowed the family straitjacket, and I chose the path far less traveled.
Wow. Now, you mentioned your dad actually tied you up. These days, that would require a visit from Child Protective Services, you know.
Well, it actually got him in a little bit of trouble. For a while, after California, my dad was in charge of the state of Oklahoma's mental health department. And I'm like 19 or 20 years old. I'm out there visiting him. I get locked up in a jail cell to do a media event. So I get out of the jail cell, you know, and the guy asked me, "Hey, how did you get started?" Well, my dad, who's in charge of the whole mental health department, used to tie me to trees, and I could always get out. And the next day, it's got a picture of me getting out of jail that says, "You earned his talent because, you know, Dr. Griffin, the state's mental health director, used to tie him to trees." Dad said, "Hey, listen, great story, but you got to be careful what you say."
America's escape hero, Michael Griffin, on the phone line. Now, he's got a show. It's a magical night out, so we're going to be combining escaping and Valentine's Day together, because the show is going to be just before Valentine's Day on Saturday, February the 10th, at the 1058 Event Center in Sandusky. Doors open at 6, got hors d'oeuvres and cocktails, dinner buffet at 7, and then your show at 8 o'clock. You may have caught him, as I mentioned before, on America's Got Talent, and Howard Stern actually tied you up on that show. But you actually got buzzed. The judges didn't like your performance, huh?
Howie Mandel just led the whole crowd in booing me, and I was just broken up. But before I was supposed to go on, I was going to do something totally different. And the producer pulled me aside, and he goes, "This is Howard's first season. You got to get Howard on stage." I said, "Well, I didn't bring anything for that. Do something." I said, "Do you guys have any rope?" Guys, yeah, he brought me like 50 feet of rope. So I explained how the rope challenge works. He goes, "Okay, great." But he said, "You cannot mention the dollar challenge, because I give away $1,000 if somebody can tie me up with the rope and I can't get out." But I said, "Here's the rub. If I get Howard up there and Howard doesn't know how to tie me up, it's going to look stupid." And he goes, "I don't care. You're a funny guy. Just get Howard up there. I've got to get Howard up there." So, yeah, I brought him up there. You know, to his credit, he tried to tie me up well. It just didn't go over well with the audience. I mean, how he summed it up beautifully. He said, "You did a great escape from nothing." God, I ought to put that on my billing.
Now, are you going to do that $1,000 offer at the 1058 Event Center, too?
We may. I mean, it pops up regularly.
Okay.
We may. You know, that's what I love about this show. It's all audience interaction. When you folks come out, my show, it's all audience interaction, but it's based on the audience. So it changes every night. No two shows are exactly alike.
We got Michael Griffin, America's escape hero, getting ready for his magical night out at the 1058 Event Center. And anybody that's in the audience that night can rest assured that they're going to be able to stay safe. I see that you actually helped capture a murderer at one of your shows.
Yeah, that was weird. That was during the rope challenge. And my assistant comes up and she goes, "Hey, Mike, there's a guy who wants to tie you up with rope, but he's really weird. Stay away from him." Well, that tells me I got to meet this guy.
Right. So I got to get him
really
up on stage.
I got to have this guy. So I go to meet the guy, and I'm talking to him before the show. I go, "So you want to be part of the rope escape?" He goes like this. He goes, "I like rope."
Oh,
I'm going,
geez.
Oh, my God. This is just like out of Christmas Story.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Then I'm being facetious, and I go, "So do you got any rope on you?" He goes, "I have rope in the trunk of my car." So the second he ties me up, I knew I'm in trouble. This guy knew exactly what he was doing. It was totally rehearsed. He's got me tied up. I don't even think I'm going to get out of this thing. I'm laying down on the stage. He's not even done. And I see the sheriff's legs walking around me. So he gets done with the rope ties. He's gone. I finally got out of the thing. And the place went nuts. But the sheriffs were all over me asking me, hey, who is that guy? And they said, well, about a year prior, there had been a couple of co-eds that were found tied up exactly the way I was tied up with what looks to be the exact same rope.
Wow.
And about 3 months later, we get a phone call. And it was the sheriff's department. He goes, well, we found the guy. And we're about 99% sure he's the guy. I said, oh, my God. He goes, yeah. Just like in a Scooby-Doo cartoon, he had to return to the scene of crime to get his jollies.
That's amazing, man. Michael Griffin, America's Escape Hero, is going to be hosting the Magical Night Out 1058 Event Center. It's going to be fun. It's going to be escapes. It's going to be a little romance, too, for Valentine's Day, right?
Those matrimonial bonds.
1058 Event Center. You can go and find info and actually some of the videos of Michael's at 1058events.com. And you have to spell out the words 1058events.com. And if you want tickets, I wouldn't wait till the night of the show because I'm guessing this is going to have to be a sellout. Give them a call at 419-624-1204 and reserve your seats in the crowd. Once again, they got hors d'oeuvres and cocktails and a buffet dinner at 7. And the show starts at 8 o'clock on Saturday, February the 10th at the 1058 Event Center.
Please come on out and see it. This is an unusual event at a world-class event center. So please come on out. It's going to be a very, very magical night. And I thank you so much for having me on your show.